What's up, guys? We're here for sushi as part of our pre-game, pre-training meal.
And it's at Sushi Nami, which is where I work.
Shout out, Sushi Nami. Alright guys, so this is what we got. Try to get the lighting. So this is called Ocean 7. It's a bunch of fish. Robin probably knows the details better than me. And then for... what did we get here? This looks like just a random assortment. Robin did the ordering, so I have no idea what it is.
It's one of the combo plates.
Looks like spicy salmon, sweet potato, some tuna, more sweet potato, California. Some red dragon, black dragon. Apparently I didn't know what it was. I'm getting better. Anyway, we're gonna smash this and then go do some squats. So stay tuned for that. All right guys, so here we go. We're starting off with the high bar squat. High bay squat, I stand corrected. That is a typo, but I'm going to leave it in there. So I'm doing 355 for four sets of four, and last week I did this same weight for sets of 10 on the low bar squat. And if you follow me on Instagram, you'll see that after four sets of that, I was dead and I just collapsed from exhaustion. That was a tough workout, but in this workout after our sushi, I was doing the high bar squats. And I'm doing those for a few reasons. The main reason being that the low bar position does still aggravate my back where I had that injury. So while I can fight through it, the high bar position does still feel more comfortable for me. So I'm incorporating some high bar squats in there. Also, to prevent my low bar squat from turning into a good morning, I find that this exercise can be corrective in that sense, even though that isn't something I really struggle with or have, you know, noticed to be a problem in the past. It is something that I want to be cognizant of, especially since I am dealing with a back injury now. So Robin is doing front squats. And this is a part of her squat development phase, which has been highly quad dominant. And if you look at her squat from 4 weeks ago and compare it to the way it looks now, it's just night and day. And Jason did a really good job of improving her squat, her low bar squat mechanics, through a combination of quad dominant exercises, including front squats and high bar squats. And if you look at her back angle in these squats and in her low bar squats and compare it to her back angle before she started the phase, like I said, the improvements are just right there in plain sight. And she's certainly come a long ways. So I'm going to do some touch and go bench presses. So sets of two with 315, and then I strip back to 225 and do five reps with that touch and go. This weight actually felt really easy. And I do this for three more sets. I've really gotten into the groove with my setup lately too, and I neglected my spotter on these next few reps just because the weight was just feeling really light in my hands that day. And the next week I actually did the same weight, 315, for four sets of three touch and go, And that was just the other day. And even that was probably an RPE of 8 or 9 at best. And I was saying that I have really gotten into a good groove with my setup. Now, I'm not going to go into my complete setup here with 225. But I found that I've really been able to get the leg drive that I wasn't really able to get before without my butt popping off the bench, but I've really tightened myself up so much in my setup that there's really no room anymore for my butt to come up. And that's something that I really find I've been able to improve over my bench capacity training phase. All right, guys, so that's it for our sushi and squats. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to like the video and subscribe if you haven't already. Thanks.